Mais c'est quoi l'intérêt? Non, Sierra 23. Bon, tu es pas emmerdé. Sierra 23, voilà. Merci. On se fait qu'en Active Sky. Active Sky, boum. All right. It's quite a proper light outside, but that'll do. Okay, so connect GPU, please. Specifier. External. Position. Red. Tail logo. See, but no smoking. Max off, taxi light off, Peter static can come on. That stays off for now. Probably should turn the screens and the radios on. So we said 71. What was the low sheeting? So if you were 25247, so how much you got there? 25247. That'll do. Total fuel 3 tons. Two. Go close enough. Load summary. That is not what I fucking asked. Like, what the fuck? 71. Twenty-five, 247. Yep, 3 turns, 2 pure. Never fucking mind. Okay. Flight plan, LFPG, that is correct. Menu. Depart. 27 left. Blah, 5 alpha. 27 left. Blah, 5 alpha. Yep. Fucking piece of shit. 8. Enter. Enter. Blah, blah. Thank you. Jesus. Boogie. Alright. No, it's that and it's list. Airways. There we go. UG42 to Louval. UG42. Yep. Louval. List. UN491. Bigger. UN491. Bigger. Boom. List and 491, the guess. N871 Madeb. Direct to Elmem. Hello, we boom. Yep. Does it know? Runway 08 says. Rattenberg 1 Bravo. Which one is that? Ah, it's the approach I fucked up. Alright. Elmem, Rattenberg, and then, yeah. Now, what is. Actually, Elmem 1A is nice. Yeah, Elmem 1A and then the special. So number 3 approach. I don't know, 3 by default, I guess. Approach. Special of DME. So Rattenberg, Adwig, Rum. Is that the one? Of the Middle East. What's the weather like? 73 knots, yeah, okay. So we are going to do the special DME. About the visual, I guess.
Sur Atmerg, Adveg, Rome. Can't remember, is this before or after? Nope, wrong one. Then it's Rome. There we go. 4711. Yeah, that looks about right. Rome Lowy. Yep. Okay. Fuel. 0 fuel weight 24945. 24945. Boom. Fuel on board. Said 3.2. Two-ish, yeah, that'll do. Gross weight 28.82, yeah, close enough. Otherwise it'll be pessimistic, that's fine. Vina will do in flight. I'm happy so far. Let's accept. And Mars Crossfill from FMS1, yep. Okay, before start, we suck fan. Where's that again? Ah, there we go. External check, yep. Our gear doors, close, no. Flight complete, yep. Before star, circuit breakers, they can't pop as far as I know. Oh, they can, okay. Well. Looks okay on this side. Looks okay on that side. Alright, I'll call it okay. Passenger signs on. Emergency lights. Nope. Okay, they are armed. Anti-skid is on. Fuel transfer quantity off, and quantity 3 tons, 2 and a bit. Yeah, that's okay. Emergency brake and pressure off, I guess. Yeah, okay, fine. Power levers disconnect. Condition levers fuel off. Takeoff data, I don't know where that is. FMC doesn't seem to be able to calculate it that I know of. Perf. Yeah, it doesn't even fucking. Why are you so goddamn useless? Seriously. Menu? Huh. Hang on. Fuel, menu, crossfill. Problem if it's. At least that's useful. There we go. Alright, okay. Start approved. Battery master may not be standby. Okay, yep. Doors, fueling light. Yep. Yep, that's all closed. That's fine. APU bleed. Off, APU's off anyway. Anti-collision. Anti-collision is red. Engines. Let's clear for start as we can. Okay. So let's start up then. Select. We are the 6th, so we're gonna start engine 2. go. 14 is plenty. Running. And there's number one. 17 fuel. I should probably get the weather, I guess. Could be useful. 211 knots. Yeah, okay, so it's gonna be crosswind from the left. Scattered low level, light rain. Okay, 10-10.
Hello? Yeah, hi, I'm very well, thank you. Slightly apprehensive, gonna be honest, and quite happy. Loads of new stuff to get my head around and some unknown, I suppose.
Run to cockpit, blood or knowledge, call me through the menu when you are ready.
Yeah.
Run to cockpit, tow is driving up. Okay, all doors and latches are closed, ready to connect. Connected and bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake. Starting pushback and you may start engines. operation complete. Set parking brake. Disconnecting tow. Stand by. Disconnected and bypass pin has been removed. Hand signal of the left. We'll see you next time on another side plate.
Seems I officially have a job now.
Alright, so engines are running, conditions level 4, no lights beside parking brake, we are flashing, taxi light can stay off, no smoking, that's fine, yep. Rear second bleeder minimum, anti-ice not needed. It's like 10 outside. Gen 1 and 2 DC okay. And 1 and 2, yep. Let's just put that off just to make sure. Steering is on. Anti-skid is on. Okay. Elevator full travel. Rudder right, left. That's fine. Flaps 10. De-ice pressure. No fucking clue. Would that be somewhere here maybe? No. Oh, never mind. Rudder travel, we checked. Steering switch, steering. Windshield heat, pilot side window heat. On, yep, that's normal. Flight taxi, taxi. Radar nav com set. Com, yeah, we don't care. Nav is set. Radar is in op, as far as I know. Yaw damper goes on. Boom, taxi. Taxi light not needed. Altimeters set. Flight instruments, 360, zero, yeah, it's all fine. Heading is roughly correct. Okay, tank aux pumps 1 and 2, 1, 2 on. Auto feather armed. Flaps are set and indicating, yep. Trims, center, center, and takeoff. Takeoff warning, does it? No, not really. Initial levers max, pedostatic heat on, ice protection not required, caution warning lights check, yep, parking brake only, flight clearance don't need, cabin secure. Alright, let's roll. Test the brakes when we're at it. Yep. Right, left, it's fine as well. I think we'll take like Quebec 3 or something. Airports, yes. LFPG. So many fucking shards. Right, we want 27 left. We'll take it at Quebec 2, that should do. And we'll rotate when it wants to rotate, should be around 130. We'll hold 10 degrees, suck up everything, and then accelerate. I should probably also check that if I'm going the right way first. Departure. Boogly. It was 5 alpha, I believe. No restrictions, okay. So it's gonna be Delta, Quebec, Quebec 2. Cheers, Evan. Alright. Yep, Delta, that's the one, going east. Running a lot better when MSFS isn't using the CPU to write shit. When I say running well, 22 FPS, but feels smooth at least. Let's double check. I think I have VSync on graphics. If I disable VSync. Not much change apparently. Probably check what the sim toolkit says I was cruising at. Not crashing already. It said 230. All right, gotcha. There's the windsock and Quebec 2. Altitude 230. Two three thousand rather. 230,000 and anything is quite impressive. Okay, nav. Eh, I should probably not do that. Unless you do petrol. Can I set... Oh, I can preset. Alright, cool. Yeah, that's gonna be a lot nicer. Alright, gas lock comes off. Full left, full right, up, down. Okay, stealth flaps 10. That is 2.7 according to my chart. Heading seems to agree. Speaking of, let's sync the bugs. Should be 2.64. Okay. Nope. Is this where I want to go? And flight rating. Let's rock and roll. Alright, let's prevent the nose from going left and the wing from coming up. Hundred twenty, 130, let's go up. Pause at the right gear. Let's do IAS and let's call it 165. Flaps up. Six for 23. And why is that VNAV showing? It's weird.
almost halfway there. Takeoff, landing gear up, yes, up, no lights, flaps 0, 0, 0, climb power, well, we're on full blast, so I guess that's climb power, bleed air 1 and 2 on as required, let's call it normal, hope the temperature's okay, normal, yeah, what do you call normal though? To look at that. Tangox bumps off. Okay, do that. Auto feather disarm. Engine temps and pressures. Everything is green. Ice protection very much required. There we go. Cabin pressure and temperature controls. We are climbing. Altitude is 6,000. It should stabilize. Pressure differential has built up. Open heater. Okay. I mean, at least we're out of the clouds, so that's fine. Passenger signs as required. Yeah, they can move about if you like. It's only an hour and a half flight. I'm not sure why they'd want to, but there we go. Altimeters, very good point. I keep forgetting those. Standard. Lights stay off. Yeah, we'll check power once we're up there. Alright. Cool. Next one is descent. That's a nice shot. Right. Bleed. Alright, let's have a look at them charts, shall we? Nope, but FPG, that ship has sailed. Lowy. Arrival. LMM. Okay, let's check. Enough. Ah. May have fucked something up here. Yes, stand by. Oh no, they do know. Hang on, let's try that one again. So, LMM, 14k and up. That plus is next. No, that's not it. Ah! Supposed to be that, right? Plus, no. 14,000 plus? No, doesn't work. Alright, X maybe? No. How the fuck do you do that? Like, surely something like 14,000 above?
No. Because why make it fucking simple to use, right? How the fuck are you supposed to program that? I mean, I'm just gonna call it fucking 14,000, fuck it. It's your own fucking problem for not being... I mean, to be fair... You fucking what? The fuck is that about? Vegas 12? What the fuck is going on here? Heidenberg is 95. Nope. What? That's much better. 14, 14, 14. I truly do not understand. David, David, David. Alright. Fly high. 900. Let's make a bit less noise. Okay. Approach. Special of DME East. So Rattenberg, Advig, 111.1. I'd really like to have, yeah, bought VOR2. Some Rattenberg, Advig. We followed the localizer down, and we have some altitudes to match. Do we have a gradient, maybe? Ground speed knots, GSR lock descent angle. Probably gonna do 160, so 1068. Okay. And then once you're at DME 4.2 from OEV, turn left to 30 at 3700. So we are close to the mountain. Wait for 3.5. And the church to a right turn and then land visually. Okay. And we still have those 50, nearly 60 knots pushing us back, pushing us forwards rather. Not gonna complain. It's just coming back that'll be a problem. Okay, I am happy with that. Do we have an altitude restriction for Advig? 21 DME, 21 DME, 21. 9500 still. Okay, let's just program that in there. Right. And Rome is 5 DME. 3900. 3900. There we go. Inshallah, that'll do. I also need to program PNAF profile. That is fine. Hang on, can you just redo the fucking calculation? We're doing 309 ground speed, 309 times 5. That is 1500. Let's try 1500. 276. 1600 maybe? Yeah, 295, that's close enough to 3. We should be okay. And I wonder if I can. Okay, menu. Nope, menu. Nope, doesn't work. List? Nope, doesn't work either. Great. Fuck it. Let's just have that in there. Right. So fucking slow. What is wrong? Okay, flaps are up, gears up. That's fairly bizarre. That's better. Why was I fucking slow? And the Lord works in mysterious ways, apparently, especially in the Q400. LFOK, isn't that like Vatry or something? Avita. Home maps. Ah, apparently the Sinai is in fucking Champagne for some reason. Good to know. Another training camp, which is extremely obvious from the air for some reason. That should be Nancy, perhaps? Ah, no, Saint-Dizier. Oh. The best, best airbase. Best one is at Nancy, obviously. Because they got the D over there. Both literally and figuratively. And we are going all the way here. JA. Oh, if only they put the fucking airfields. I don't need a sort of map. I want a proper aeronautical one. Tell you what, let's go visit the cabin since we can. Yes, entirely pointless yet. A3 ground speed, holy shit! We are hauling ass, that is quite impressive. I suspect stuff like the Gulfstream and shit are blowing quite hard this time of year. Yep, wind, and let's go. Yeah, 240. Oh, yep. Yep. That is 135 knots. And if we go up to jet altitudes. Still a bit weak for going along the Med, I guess. But for the people who enjoy their cross the ponds, they're gonna be a home early for dinner. Ah, that's better. Still can't believe we're doing 400 knots across the ground. That's pretty mad. Did it room? Yeah, high performance though.
Have I heard there's multiple styles?
I must say, I like that one a bit better.
That wing is so weird. It's teeny tiny. Like a specific mode again. So what? Maybe the documentation has something. No, you don't give a shit. Aircraft. Tutorial, I guess. Yes, I know how to do all that. I just need to know what to set my shit to on cruise. Yep, I know how to do that. 10,005 degrees is one way to do it. So I should set 850 in the cruise, apparently. Alright. Do I just put fucking flight rating or something? Rating the tent, and apparently I don't touch it until there. But let's experiment. Flight rating 850. Let's see what that nets us. Less noise for one. Still fairly high though. Such a big fan. Torque for 850 rpm. I mean, that does seem fairly arbitrary and correct. So maybe. Oops. Maximum continuous something. MCR. Yeah. Honestly, don't know. Just gonna stay off. Alright, we're there. And at Bega, we finally cross out of France. Roger that. EPL is. Ah, Épinal. Good point. Also former airbase, quite clearly. Yeah, Épinal-Mirecourt. I mean, why it's called Épinal-Mirecourt is pretty strange, since Épinal is there, but I suppose it's a naming convention of some sort. Colmar, also a air base, I believe. A single weather cell. I need to check if there are any night rules regarding night for the DME. Establish effective visual reference. Ten 1P pages. All right. Nope. Airport. 10 1P. Noise abatement, don't care. Low visibility. No. That's not it. Mach turbulence in the air general. Extensive glider activity. I should hope so, given the terrain. Well, doesn't say if we can't do it at night, so I'm gonna do it at night. Vega's in sight at about 60 miles.
Ah. As much as I love doing falling nuts above the ground, I'm gonna the fuel burn seems a lot nicer.
Helpful.
It's a shame I started the flight so late, can't even see the Alps.
Oh well.
double check VORs. So I'm arriving manually to Hardenberg. 111.1 is set on ILS 2. Course is 254. All the way down to 4.2, and then we turn, and it's visual from then on. Why would I need run a 97 though? Half of the mist, I guess. Oh, this is a flight sim, we don't go mist. Minus to the descent, right? Cool. ZUE, let me guess, Zurich. ED something, that's Germany. Yeah. So the Rhine should be pretty much here. Things are getting a bit bright for me. That's better. 126.03. Wait. 70 at 3 knots, 10:14. It's ground speed as well. It's gonna be more complicated. Lock descent angle. Doesn't say if there's a glide slope that I know of. Yeah, course offset and shit. That's okay. Or maybe I'm just stupid and lock implies something like a shouldn't. Lock is always the lateral part in an ILS. I suppose we'll see. 254.111. Let me program that as well. Boom. Side, so sucker. Now the 500s on minimum. I'll select VNAV. Yes, I know. Death Path is approaching. Okay, Vinafar selected, and we are descending. The fact that I can't even see what's outside and I'm descending towards a mountain chain is mildly terrifying, I have to say. Did I have a transition altitude? I suspect it's quite high. No, not the minimum, the transition. Transition leveled by ATC. Okay. That doesn't help me much. Let's put it to fuck it. Local QNH in advance. Not that 27 feet will matter, but let's just say that if 27 feet matter, there's a lot we did wrong. I probably could have planned the descent a bit better, but I don't know how to enter fucking 14,000 and above in that fucking UNS. Can't be as simple as putting an A in the fucking data field. Where would be the fun in that? This is why you don't reinvent the fucking wheel. I can see our destination. and also going in there without a fucking terrain radar that I know of anyway. So inshallah we don't crash in the side of the fucking map. Yep. Yay. Hertwig. 2-5-4-1-1-1 descend at 1100. At 4.2 turn 230, 3700 feet. Yeah, I suppose it's a visual anyway, but keep it 3700, turn to follow the power lines, and a 3.5 from 111.1, turn and land. Okay, that seems clear enough. Okay, altimeter set, approach landing briefing review, cabin out control set. Landing altitude like about 1700 or something. No, it's more like 2000. Alright. There we go. Ice protection is required. It is on. Approach. Altimeters set. Lights. I mean, we might as well. You never know, we might end up seeing something. GPWS landing flaps 35. Yep, fuel transfer off. It's stead off. Tank box pumps 1 and 2 on. Standby pressure and PTU control on. Sorry, this is on as well. Hydraulic pressure quantity pressures are all fine except for 3. No idea why. Plus the quantities are all absolutely up. Passenger signs. Yeah, I should probably tell them to go back to their seats. Caution warning lights. None. Cabin secure. Landing. Hold at Hardenberg, maybe. Yes, we do. Alright, inbound is 225. Time doesn't specify a time. Other distance, I guess I'm gonna leave it to. First hold in the dash A. It's gonna give me time to configure properly. go for config. Then we're gonna do one hold at Hardenberg. Entry teardrop. That is correct. Show me what you got for this. Yeah, and we're in the middle of the Alps. How do you think I feel?
So we're doing this hold, and then we're gonna come back, go to Advig, and then do the approach fully. So descend along this way at 4.2 turn there, follow this, and after we see a church, we turn right and go land. Buddy, you should be turning now. Oh goodness. So got no heading. Haha, do as you see fit, my god. That joke hasn't aged at all. Yeah, speaking of see fit, looks like I'm going to do one. I can see a valley, so it's not completely fucking lost. So I'm in manual mode now. Okay, let's try this one again. AP. That's what you need to shut the fuck up. I'll oblige you. And I'll even go fucking full flaps. Much ballooning, holy shit. I think I would qualify for this approach. I am making quite a mess of it. Can you let me double check the fucking weather?
Ah! Suck. Okay, yeah, it's not updated. Well, fuck it, we'll do it live. Okay, let's see if I can... We seem to be, yeah, we have captured, and it says ILS. Okay, what if I do this, nav source, okay, yeah, that pleases me so far, and we have a glide slope for some reason. It's gonna make my life a lot easier. So now we're waiting to approach the course we want to be down on. Course is 254 course. Let me double check. Yep, that is correct. So 254 all the way down. We even have the luxury of a fucking glide. Yeah, the wind has started to shift, so it seems we're gonna do that zero weight approach after all. Descend that, follow the glide up to 4.2, turn to 230. Once we're down there, that's right, buddy. And then turn back whenever we can see anything. All right, let's go. Approach even. Let's not stall in the process. That would be bad. From the north. Alright, we are about to intercept the glide slope apparently. Glide is there, shows we're slightly below. And I think we're having trouble because of ridge lift. I think there's a ridge just below us there, so it's probably ballooning us upwards. It would be fun if we could actually see it. So this is pretty much how you don't fly this thing. Yep. Okay, we passed 17. At 17 we want to be at 8700 and below. Yeah, way too high. I suppose in this context it's better to be high than low. Okay, lock star, so it's following it. Yep, we are tracking. Okay, that's a lot better. Still doing the 230. 7 knots. Approaching 14, 7500. Slightly high now. 13, we want to be at 71. We look to be on course. Yep, we are bang on. It's nice. Next stop is at 9, and we're to be 5500. Glide slope captured. Perfect. Yeah, if the wind maintains, I'm just going to do the normal ILS, because the wind is coming from the west anyway. I can't see shit, and it's a dangerous approach as it is, and I've been fucking it up. So let's do that. Starting to see the ground again. Yeah, we're gonna do the normal ILS then. I was gonna end in a visual because that's offset. Dot above. Jesus. It's starting to come back. And when I have the FF in sight, I'll just go manual and visual. Thousand to go. Come on. Yeah, I'm glad I'm not doing the fucking visual approach. My plane, visual on the airport. Gas down 3 green, seatbelts and stuff is on. We are full flaps set and indicating. Airport is in sight. We are pretty much on speed. And we still have wind as variables. Better. Two voice, two red, we ain't gonna be dead. And speaking of turboprop sounds, you're gonna have the best ones pretty soon. Gotta say, this is pretty fucking scenic. Let's see if I can manage to not plonk this down like an F-18. That was sporty. Fucking hell. Turbo props, best props. Well, I'm glad to be on the ground. I'm sure if we had a better lighting engine, it would be a bit better. Although, to be fair, with those low clouds, probably wouldn't have mattered much. Especially Judas Priest is better with turbo. CRJ of some kind. some reason the Dornier, whatever, the 328, I think, is really popular in X-Plane. Do we have any parking spaces? Inshallah, next to the 737. X-Plane Autogen, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Motherfuckers. Alright, let's go park at the back. Ah, that looks like a spot. I'll take it. GPU, please. Go. External power, external power, and off, off. Wing inspection. Red. There we go. Alright. Oh, and now we can see. Yeah, it's better when there's no clouds in it. Yeah. And where's that church supposed to be? I think it's this one. Yeah, go there, turn, and then you end up doing... Yeah, looks like that's it. Alright, start loading. Screenshot for posterity. And let's see if we can get some replay action, shall we? Possibly not with the... Alright. So the X-Plane replay is only slightly better than the ECS one. I mean, at least it traces your adventures fully, but... Look at that wobble. Let's have a look at that carrier landing. I don't get it. Maybe I just started too high? Well, I just cut the power too quickly, maybe. Because yeah, I can't really increase my flare angle. Ah, that compression. Jesus. Oh, and now there's a A220? Alright. That was it.